Welcome to all. In this video, we will discuss about module number 5 and the topic is linear algebra. In this topic, we discuss one subtopic, that is consistent condition for the consistency and the types of solution. Okay. By using this method, easily we have to find unknown variables. Okay. So let's move the procedure. So condition for consistency and type of solution. So we have to consider a system of m equations and n unknown represented in this matrix. See the matrix. This is the A matrix, and this is the A matrix is nothing, a coefficient of matrix. For example, if the any one equation, if the example 5x plus 6y plus 7z equal to 10. Okay. So A is nothing, a coefficient of matrix. So 5, 6 and 7. This 5 is denoted by A11 and this is A12 and this is A13. So the constant, it's a coefficient of A matrix, that is a A. Okay. And remaining X, another one is X. X is unknown variables, X, Y and Z. Maybe it's a X1, Y1. X1, X2 and X3. Okay. So X is the unknown variables and B is a constant. Each one. So 10. Okay. So this is the matrix represented by this equation represented by the matrix. So here A is called coefficient of matrix and AB. Okay. It is called augmented matrix. Clear. So we have collect only the AB. So the system of equation represented by the matrix equation AX equal to B. Okay. If row of A, what is row of A meaning? Rank of A. Rank of A equal to rank of AB. Rank of A equal to rank of AB. Suppose rank of A equal to rank of AB equal to R. Then the condition for two types of solution as follows. So if rank of A equal to rank of AB equal to R means we get two type of solution. What is the two type of solution? We'll discuss one by one. So the first solution is a unique solution. When it is unique solution, if rank of A equal to rank of AB equal to R equal to N. What is R? R is a non-zero rows and N is a number of unknowns, that is number of variables. Okay. So if row of A equal to row of AB equal to R equal to N means we get unique solution. Another result, infinite solution. When we get infinite solution, if row of A equal to row of AB equal to R but less than N. Okay. Less than n, for r is a 2 and n is the 3 means, okay, we get infinite solution. In this case, n minus r unknowns can be take arbitrary values. What is arbitrary values? For example, we can take k, w, b like this, r, u. Okay, so arbitrary constant. After substituting constant, we get the constant. This is one solution. One more solution is there. If row of A not equal to row of AB, rank of A is not equal to rank of AB, we get inconsistent. There is no solution. We can't do the next one. That is the does not process a solution. Okay. So if row of A equal to row of AB means we get two type of solution. One is unique solution. Another one is infinite solution. When it is unique solution, row of A equal to row of AB equal to R equal to N means we get unique solution. Or row of A equal to row of AB equal to R less than N means we get the infinite solution. Infinite solution means many more solution. And another result, if in case row of A not equal to row of AB, rank of A not equal to rank of AB means there is no solution. Okay. So now we will discuss the problem. So first consider the test for the consistency and solve. So our aim is to find the value of x, y, z, okay, by the condition. Okay, so this is the matrix. The matrix, the form is AX equal to B. Yeah, AX equal to B. What is A? A is the coefficient matrix. What is the coefficient matrix? So coefficient of the first row is here 1, 1, 1. And coefficient of second row is 1, minus 1, 2. And the third row is 3, 1, 1. So this is A. And X is the given variables. There are three variables. One is X, another one is Y, another one is Z. Equal to, this is B. What is B? One is 6, another one is 5, another one is 8. Okay, so A is the, this is the coefficient of matrix, and this is the variable, and this is the constant for the right hand side. Clear? Now compare AB. So this is A is to, this one is B. So this matrix is called augmented matrix. Okay, so next we have to following the procedure. Is the procedure is nothing, already we know how to solve the, how to find the rank of matrix. Here also the same procedure we have to follow. So we have to find the rank of matrix. Okay, that same echelon form like this. Okay, so the main concept is we have to create here upper triangular matrix. That's all. The main thought is we have to create here upper triangular matrix. That meaning is we have to create here 0, we have to make here 0, we have to make here 0. So we'll discuss one by one. So first we have to make here 0. Simply I subtract this R2 minus R1. Okay, so see, in this R2 I subtract minus R1 and I add R2. So 1 minus 1 0, 1, this is minus 1 minus 1 is a minus 2, and 2 minus 1 is a 1, and 5 minus 6 is a minus 1. Okay, the first one is completed. And next we have to make here 0. Okay, by using the R1. What is R1? Here the first variable is, first constant is 1, and here 3. So I multiply minus 3 and I add. I multiply minus 3 in R1 and I add. If you multiply minus 3 in R1, we get minus 3 plus 3 and plus 3 and 18. Next, what is R3? R3 is 3, 1, 1, 8. Clear? If you subtract, this is 0. So this is minus. Okay, this is minus, this is minus, everything is minus. So we get minus 2 and minus 2 and minus 10. Clear? So we got here 0 and here 0. So next we have to make here 0. How to make here 0? Compare to like this, compare to this one. Here minus 2, here minus 2. So it's nothing in R3. Then R3 is nothing. Just I multiply minus into R2. After that, I add R3. Now I will get the 0. Okay. So R3 minus R2. So we get the upper triangular matrix. So the process is completed. Now check the rank of matrix only for the A. Don't consider this one. Only for the A. So rank of A is 3. How we get the 3 is an unknown variable. Okay. So rank of A be equal to 3. R is the non-zero rows. Is also 3. And the equation consistent will have the unique solution. Y n also 3. So we compare the equation. So this is x plus y plus z equal to 6. This is minus 2y plus z equal to minus 1. And this is minus 3z equal to minus 9. By solving this equation, we get x, y, z values. Okay. So that's all. So I hope you are all understanding this concept. Okay. So the process is nothing. We solve the given matrix by the upper triangular. We can convert the upper triangular matrix. After that, we can compare the rank of matrix. Okay. There are two solutions. This unique solution. Okay, unique solution means we get only one solution in the each value. When we get unique solution, rho of A equal to rho of AB equal to N equal to R. Here we get the unique solution. and another one is we get the infinite.